In this video, we're going to take a look at another one of my favorite new features with iOS 17 on the iPhone, shared password groups. What we're able to do is create a group of passwords and share those with other people. So if they want to use those passwords or even update them, what they're able to do is use them within their autofill and update them, and I can do the same. We're sharing that password. Let's take a look at how these shared password groups work on the iPhone. Let's go over to my iPhone. Now, the first thing that we need to do is we need to create a shared group. So what we do is we go over to our settings here. This is where we manage our passwords. So I swipe up, and what you're going to see is passwords here. Now, when I tap on this, you're going to see that nothing really looks that different. All of these passwords here are my own personal passwords. Well, what I would like to do is share this ARP password with Abigail Appleseed. So then what she's able to do is access it or even update it. She can use it in her autofill. So how do we do that? Well, the first thing that we have to do is create a shared group. So I tap on the plus in the upper right-hand corner, and you're going to see new shared group. From here, what I do is I tap on continue. This card just kind of tells us what we're going to be doing. I name the group. So I'm just going to call this Abigail Passwords. And from here, I tap on, whoops, we got to fix the typo there. From here, what I do is I tap on add people. I created the name. Now I need to add people, meaning I have to go and add Abigail. So from here, what I do is I tap on Abigail, and I tap on Add. Now, I could go and add more people if I want to. Also, what this does is this sends out an invitation to Abigail. What she'll have to do is she'll have to accept that invitation. We'll see how that works shortly. So next thing that I do is I tap on Create. This is going to create that shared group. I haven't added any passwords yet. We're going to do that shortly. Now what it's going to tell me is which devices are incompatible with shared passwords. This only works with iOS 17 or greater, iPadOS 17 or greater, or macOS Sonoma or greater. So if you're using an older version of macOS or iOS or iPadOS, you will not be able to use these shared groups. And we can see which devices in our accounts here are unavailable for shared groups. So in this case here, my MacBook Pro is unavailable for shared groups. I'm okay with that. Abigail is actually using this MacBook Air, which is using macOS Sonoma, and we can use shared groups. So I'm going to tap on continue here at the very top here. And then I just tap on the passwords I want to share, and we can add more down the road. We're just going to go with the ARP one right now. Now, when we create a password, what we're actually doing is we're moving that password. So it's moving it from my passwords over to that shared group. We are not copying it, we're moving it. So now I tap on move, it's going to move that over. Now what I need to do is I need to notify Abigail. She needs to know that she has this shared group available, and she has to accept that invitation. So I go and tap on notify via messages. This is typically how you would do it. I tap on send, and now what it did is it sent an invitation to her via messages. Now, before we go and take a look at how Abigail works with this, let's take a look at the screen here. You're going to see that there are two members, myself, of course, and then we have Abigail. Now, right now, Abigail is invited, but she hasn't accepted it yet, so we can kind of see what the status is here. If I want to add more people, I can do that, and I can go and delete the group altogether. When we delete the group, it does move the password back into your passwords. I want to add more passwords. I can do that as well. I tap on the plus here, and you're going to see I can move more passwords to that group. Or what I'm able to do is just create a new password. I can also add more people here. And when I tap on an individual password, let's go to add this. Let's say I wanted to move this over there. You're going to see what group it's in. I can go and tap on this, and I can move it over to Abigail's password. So let's go ahead and do that. It's going to move that over to that group. All right, so now we have this group created. We have a couple of passwords in there. Let's see how this works from Abigail's point of view. Now, we're going to look at this on macOS Sonoma. Abigail has an account on Johnny's MacBook Air. So let's go over to her account, and you're going to see that she has this message here. So now what she needs to do is she needs to click on this. It's going to open up the settings app and take her over to passwords. So I type in the password here for Abigail. And what you're going to see here is an invitation to Abigail's passwords. So now all she has to do is just accept this. When she accepts it, she's going to have a new group in her passwords. Now from here, what she's able to do is choose passwords as well. She can move passwords that she has into this group as well. So click on choose passwords, and if she wanted to move demo over there, she can do that. And now we have these three passwords that she has access to. And when we go back over to Johnny's iPhone, you're going to see that we have Abigail's passwords here, and we have those same three passwords. These do work with autofill, so as Abigail is using the computer or the iPhone or her iPad, she'll be able to autofill with these as well as Johnny. It is a shared password. And again, it does move them, it doesn't copy them, so you don't have to worry about duplicate passwords. Now, you are able to move these from within the shared group as well, but there's a little bit of a catch. You can only move passwords that you've added. So Johnny added this ARP password, so he wants to move it back into his passwords. So let's go ahead and tap on it, and you're going to see that he can tap on Abigail's passwords and move it back over to his own passwords. But when we go over to the password that Abigail shared, she shared demo, remember? I tap on it. You're going to see that Johnny can't move that group because Abigail shared this. So what you would have to do, or what Abigail would have to do, is go into her account on the Mac, and then she'd be able to move this into her own passwords. So you're able to move passwords, but only passwords that you've moved. So if you try to move a password that you can't, that's because someone else added it to that group. Now, as I mentioned earlier, you can also remove a group. When you do that, what it'll do is it'll move those passwords back to their respective sources. So let's go back over to the iPhone here. And what we're going to do is go over to the group here. I'm going to tap on Manage. And if I go and delete this group, what it's going to do is move my passwords that I've added to that over back into my passwords. And if Abigail added any passwords, it would move her passwords back into her password. So it doesn't necessarily delete any passwords. It just moves them back to their original spot or their original group. You can have more than one group. All you have to do is just tap on the plus here and you can create another group. So that is how shared passwords work with the iPhone and iOS 17. As I mentioned, this is one of my favorite new features. I think this is really nice. I can see myself using this with my wife, Beth. We have a couple of accounts that we have, or we can both log into. It's the same account. So now what we're able to do is share that one password with each other. So if I change that password, it'll show up changed on her computer. She changes the password, it'll show up changed on my computer. So that is how shared passwords work with iOS 17 on the iPhone.